flags.
This might be part of the march though.
We didn't bring any flags with us.
No, they're in the backpack.
Well, I'm just, well, we don't have any.
We got this?
Yeah. Fashion it to the walking stick. There we go.
You know.
So there are no restrooms around.
Nope.
So we'll just have to keep moving. No, sir.
Seen any around?
No, they're Union Station or Union Station or.
So there's First Street going that way.
So if I just keep walking, I'm okay, unless.
Wait up, Uncle Chris. Don't let me lose.
Well, yeah, I'm not dying right now. I just don't want to get to the point where I'm dying.
You want to walk this way?
Sure. Let's see what's closer. I got my phone in my pocket.
Say, Liz, come back this one.
Station. Let's go ahead and go there. I'd like to, and then I'd be good. Okay?
Okay, well, we're in a clear spot.
I gotta look and see what's going on.
The Union Station Christmas tree. So we're heading back up.
Sorry?
Not talking to my camera. No. We're heading back up to the festival. All right. So this is the Supreme Court.
Thank you, patrons, for coming out today. This is such a beautiful background.
She's just saying there was riots last night.
Oh.
I'm walk this way a little bit.
Amen and God bless you.
I'm literally right in the middle of the jungle.
Thank you guys, thank you.
There's been a lot of confusion because there are so many people here to stand up for our president. That's a good problem to have if you ask me.
There's a sidewalk right up here.
The only way we're going to save our republic is by
on communicating and networking and taking to the streets with one another. This is the action that has to happen, or we lose our republic. And what could be more shameful than being part of the generation that doesn't pass the blessings of liberty onto our children? You guys get it. We gotta get more people to get it. So when you go home, you go meet in your communities, one-on-one, meet off, out, offline, away from the control of the big tech oligarch. But I just saw somebody on the-
Stop the steal! 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 Stop the steal!
So here's where we go from here. In Georgia, there's a major lawsuit that's working its way through the courts about the over...
There was something called the three-fifths compromise. Everyone remember that? That's when a black person was deemed to be three-fifths of a vote. Three-fifths of a human being. And then in 1857, another black slave tried to fight for his freedom, Dred Scott. And this Supreme Court struck him down, 7-2. And they said that he was not a citizen, and he was only three-fifths of a vote. And then we have the 14th. And the other thing was one person, one vote. Now, I ran for United States Senate in Massachusetts. Just like President Trump, we won that on a landslide. And the GOP establishment and the Democrats colluded, just like they did against our great president. So we have got to realize in this country that we must start following the right leadership. And the reason we're here today with election fraud, with forced vaccinations, with these mask mandates and lockdowns is because we forgot who our real leaders are. Our real leaders are you, the American working people. The American working people have always led movements that have inspired the entire world. Not politicians, not judges.
Head over to the Freedom Plaza.
And we have been watching it happen in the Congress. What they have done now has awakened, and I close with this. December 7th, 1941, the Japanese had taken over the Philippines, taken over China. They wiped out the Pacific Fleet. And Admiral Yamamoto said this on that Sunday, December 7th. He said, I fear that we have awakened and that we have filled him with tremendous resolve. We know what they did. We have not been involved.
Got it on now. Oh yeah. It's a sad little van almost. Restore our constitution. Funny. under Trumpy. A little Merry Christmas, Santa, in the middle of the street.
What?
Capital back
there. Got a little military back there.
Boy contingency. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. No. Yeah. Yeah. Mad Mike.
Is it my imagination?
Nope. That's it.
Was it Mad Mike? Wild somebody. Wild Mike. USA, USA,
USA,
USA,
USA,
USA. Air Force One just went over the helicopters.
Thank you.
going in, that's for sure. It's a Trumpy warrior. Say no to crack, people.
Thank you. grace of God. Grace yourself in the word of God. Grace yourself in the fellowship of believers. Grace yourself. Because Jesus said in the world, you will have tribulation. But we can get better. Our brothers and sisters in other countries have had tribulation for a long time.
It's a big contingency of Proud Boys in front of us. They're a mass. Women for Trumpy buses.
And I saw the returns coming in Florida for President Trump, Ohio for President Trump, Iowa for President Trump. We knew North Carolina was going for President Trump. And on and on and on. And when we went to bed that night, we knew that President Trump was going to have four years. tell you that as sure as I am that I'm standing here with all of you beautiful Americans, I am sure that President Trump won this election.
Hey, Boo, or huh?
What we have to do, what we have to fight for, is to count every legal vote and to make sure that the electors who are counted on January 6th represent the legal votes of you, the American people. Count the votes, 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 count the legal votes. Here's the deal. Do not forget that starting on November 4th, all across the country, the mainstream media and their comrades on the Democrat side told us it was over. They said, go home, nothing to see here. There's not over 220,000 illegal ballots in Wisconsin. There's not over 400,000 illegal ballots in Georgia. There's not almost 700,000 mail-in absentee ballots counted without any observers in Pennsylvania. They tried to lie to us all across the country and send us home. But are we going to be deterred? Are we going to be sent home? Are we going to accept the steal? Or are we going to stop the steal? I want to see those flags. I want to see the flags. Stop the steal. 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 So here's where we go from here. In Georgia, there's a major lawsuit that's working its way through the courts about the over 400,000 illegal ballots cast in the state of Georgia. Do not forget, the margin is only about 13 to 14,000. In Pennsylvania, the Mike Kelly, the Congressman Mike Kelly lawsuit has filed for a petition for certiorari to the Supreme Court. In Michigan, litigation goes on. In Wisconsin, today, the Trump campaign is going to be in the Wisconsin Supreme Court fighting about the over 220,000 illegally cast ballots in Wisconsin. We will not give up on Wisconsin. Arizona, Chairwoman Kelly Ward, a real patriot, is now petitioning to the Supreme Court, and we'll continue to work on Nevada and New Mexico. All across the country, we are fighting for. Do you want us to fight? Do you want us to fight? Do you want us to give up? Do we want 4 more years? Give it to me. 4 more years.
4 more years.
I want to thank the organizers of this event, the one and only Amy Kramer and her wonderful daughter, Women for Trump, and all the groups who are coming together to...
Are we going to have 4 more years of President Trump?
Yes!
4 more years!
By the grace of God.
4 more years! 4 more years! 4 more years! 4 more years!
Without any observers in Pennsylvania. They tried to lie to us all across the country and send us home. But are we going to be deterred? Are we going to be sent home? Are we going to accept the steal? Or are we going to stop the steal?
don't even read it. They don't even look at it. They swear an oath to defend it. They don't even know what it says. I know this. It guarantees the right to vote. And if they want to take away our right to vote, it is not going to be free. Who are we going to be defeated so easily by? We're talking about men who wear women's clothes. They wear skinny jeans. They weigh 120 pounds. They can't go in the sun. And they live in San Francisco because they can't live anywhere else. This is who we're going to be defeated by? By Jack Dorsey? This nation is going to be conquered by Mark Zuckerberg? Are you kidding? We can't even speak about this. We are strong now. Right now, we are strong. In 10 years, if this censorship continues, what will we be as a conservative party? We will be gone. We won't even remember each other's names because we won't be able to talk to each other. But right now, we are the many. We are the majority. We are the vote. We all know the suitcase is full of ballots. We all know that these people are illegitimate. And right now,
Georgia. There's not almost 700,000 mail-in absentee ballots counted without any observers in Pennsylvania. They tried to lie to us all across the country and send us home. But are we going to be deterred? Are we going to be sent home? Are we going to accept the steal? Or are we going to stop the steal? I want to see those